Hello everyone, today I am going to be reviewing the prehistoric mammal skulls tube from Safari Ltd. And I think it's a pretty nice set. It comes with 8 skull figures, all animals from the Cenozoic era, so let's just dive right in. So first here we have the Australopithecus, yeah, very closely related to human beings. That's how the origins of mankind started out. And it's a pretty well-crafted skull. You can see the teeth lineage right here, the bottom jaw, and if you could see all the markings on the skull, and then it has the label right there, Australopithecus. Pretty nice skull, pretty humanoid-like, but also pretty ape-like, because it's somewhere in between when it comes to these species. Yeah, very well crafted skull. And then now we have the Embolotherium. Forgive me if I'm not pronouncing that correctly. Looks like a species of rhino. You can see where the skull attached to the spine. You can see the way the head is shaped right here. And if you look at the bottom jaw, and then the teeth, and then the top jaw, pretty big, long, elongated snout and mouth, and you can see the nostril skulls right there. And if you look at the horn, kind of heart-shaped-ish. Look at the teeth, the mouth is slightly opened a little, and if you look in the eye sockets, and then you can see the brown markings and the pretty vivid detail of this skull. Yeah, pretty impressive design. And then if you look here at the Arsenotherium skull, this creature may look like a rhino, but it was actually more closely related to elephants. Yeah, looks can be very deceiving. So it kind of has 2 horns on its skull, kind of like a mammal version of a triceratops. And if you look at the nostril, it goes straight through. And if you look at the jaw lineage right here, you can see the teeth and then the skull, and then it has 2 horns right here. And if you want to look in the eye socket, bottom jaw, you can see where it connects to the spine. It's kind of a lighter brownish color compared to the other skulls. Still the same markings. And then here we have the Uintatherium. Kind of has like the horns of a giraffe right here. And if you look at the where the nose is, pretty well crafted design. And those big teeth right there, and then the teeth inside. Pretty well crafted. See the horns, and then you can see where the eye socket is, bottom jaw. Pretty bizarre animal. And then here we have a woolly rhinoceros, a woolly rhino. Had a very long horns. The front horn is longer than the second horn. Pretty curved. And if you look at the eye socket, if you look at the teeth, pretty well aligned, pretty has pretty nice dental care. And if you smell, look at the nostrils, rhinos had a very good sense of smell. And the woolly rhino was about the same size as today's modern day rhinos. You can see where the skull attaches to the spine. Yeah, woolly rhinos are pretty impressive animals. And then right here we have the Deodon, which was an extinct species, a prehistoric pig. And if you look at the jawline, his mouth is closed, but the teeth are still bared out. And then those bony plates that stick out on the skull. You're pretty, kind of looks like a alligator mixed with a pig or something like that. Yeah, this was also one of the very many species of pigs that were known as the hogs from hell. You can see the eye socket. Yeah, pretty well designed. Same dark color as the other skulls, brown markings. And then here we have the skull of a mastodon, which was an extinct species of elephant. If you want to look, you could see the teeth right there, the bottom jaw of the skull. It's a straight through hole through the eye sockets. And then if you look at the tusks are pretty straight, a little curved a little, but pretty straight, not very separated. Kind of wonder how it would manage to slip its trunk through there. Yeah, and then you see those teeth. Teeth are one of the most defining features of the mastodon. It's one of the main differences between mastodons and mammoths, which people often get confused with. You could see that that's where the trunk would attach. Yeah, the mastodon, the American mastodon, was a pretty big species of elephant. Not nearly as big as a mammoth, but still a pretty big animal. And then finally, we have the skull of a saber-toothed cat, Smilodon. One of my favorite prehistoric animals. Yeah, you want to look at the bottom jaw, his mouth is open. And then, of course, there are those defining features, the long saber teeth, which he had grown up to nearly 12 inches in length. The bigger the cat, the bigger the teeth. If you want to look inside the nose, and then the eye socket. And it is thought that Sabertooth didn't have a very strong bite, but in my opinion, it didn't need a strong bite because these teeth were designed for stabbing, not crushing. And as we all know, these teeth were also very fragile and could snap if they collided with bones. So yeah, as a prehistoric mammal lover, I think this is a pretty nice set, definitely worth your money. I got this set at Michael's for $10, so it was a pretty good price for what they offer here. I personally think it's a very nice set, but that's it for now. Hope you enjoyed this review, and I'll see you guys later.